Hey everyone, this is Kirk here again from OptionAlpha.com, and I wanted to quickly record this video talking about expected move because we actually just made an earnings trade about 10 minutes ago and we sent out the alert to our members, but it's a great example of how you can use option pricing and straddle pricing to calculate expected move. But I'm also going to show you a couple tips because inside thinkorswim they already do this for you, so you don't actually have to do it yourself in most cases. So we're looking at the stock today, MON, which is Monsanto, and we've traded this a bunch of times before, been very profitable for us trading this around earnings. And you can see that the stock does have earnings which come out tomorrow. So as we always do with these earnings trades, we're trading it just the day before the stock announces earnings, which is tomorrow before the open. So we just made the trade. It's about 3:45 in the afternoon before the market closed. So as close as we can get towards that end of the day, like we talk about all the time. Now, when we actually go in to look and see where the stock might go, we're going to go to the trade tab. And I've already got up our position here with Monsanto. And you can see this is the exact trade price that we have. So we sold a strangle on the weeklies. And we did so at the 121 calls, which you can see here, and then also the 112 puts, which you can see here on the screen. So everything that I'm showing you here is obviously live and working orders. Now, inside thinkorswim, it's got a really cool feature, and you're able to actually just visually see what the expected move is by just going over here to this MMM that shows up as earnings come up for a particular stock. So this MMM is the market maker move for this stock, and it's basically telling you up or down what the expected move is for this stock for earnings. Now, this is kind of subjective, right? Because people always ask, like, well, what does that expected move mean? I mean, I understand that, you know, the stock could go up or down by about $2.94, but what does that really encompass? Well, that encompasses about a one standard deviation move. And so as you've probably seen in a bunch of our videos, that's pretty much how most of the probability indicators are calculated, with this one standard deviation move. So right now, based on the pricing of Monsanto's, and we always take the closest contract pricing, in this case, it's the January weeklies, which only have about 3 days left. Based on all of this pricing and data for the stock, and it's very liquid, it's got a lot of shares, the market is pricing in that at earnings, it could move somewhere between $3 up or down based on its current price. So this is really helpful because, as you can see, what we've done is we've gone just a little bit beyond that level on both ends to give ourselves enough room to be right on this trade. So we want to make this trade with as high of a probability of success as possible, and we're probably looking at about a little over a 70% chance of success. The probability that it moves down below 112 is about 14%, and the probability that it moves above 121 is about 14% as well, kind of give or take with the market moving here. You can see we're pretty neutral and balanced to the trade and the position right now. But a lot of questions, or one question that I get often is, well, Kirk, what if my broker doesn't have that MMM up there in the top right-hand corner? What if I have to manually calculate where that position is? And I'm going to show you a really cool way to do that, and it has to do with using the at-the-money straddle price. So what we're going to do is, and I'll go over two different examples, one kind of live, and then I'll show you a different example with Twitter and just a kind of little chart that we have. But one way you can do it is you go to the at-the-money straddle. Now, in this case, we're going to go to the closest strike that's at the money. And with the stock trading live right now at 116.74, we're going to go to the 117 at-the-money straddle. So we're just going to go in here and right-click and pretend like we're going to sell that at-the-money straddle. Okay, so it's going to bring up this pricing dialog box down here. And you can see now that the credit for the at-the-money straddle is 325. So that's the credit that we're going to work with. So here's the formula for how to calculate any expected move. And you can do it with any probability range you want. You take the credit that you see down here. And in this case, that credit is 325. So I'm just going to write it out on the screen here so that we can see it. So we take that 325 credit. We times that credit by the probability that we want to see. So in this case, we want to do a one standard deviation move, which is an 84% probability range. So we're going to times the credit down here, which is 325, by our expected range, which is 84. And then we're going to divide that figure by the current stock price. Okay, so we're going to divide that figure by the current stock price, which is 116.78. Okay, so again, hopefully you can see it here. I know I'm drawing just right on the screen, but I just want to make sure that you guys can see how to do this. We take the credit of the at the money straddle, which is currently the closest strike at 117. We times that first by the probability that we're looking to get, that range that we're looking to get, an 84% chance of success range. And now we take that probability, if we want to get that expected move, we want to take that probability and we want to divide it by 116.78, okay? So if you actually go ahead and do this, and I'm just doing this on my calculator on my phone right here, so 325 times 0.84 divided by 116.78 gives us an expected move percentage-wise of 2.337. Okay, so that's the actual expected move percentage-wise that we're looking at. Now, you can take that percentage and then times that percentage by saying, okay, if the stock is expecting to make a percentage move of about 2.337, what does that equate to in dollar terms? So we take that percentage move and we times it by 116.70, which is where the stock is trading right now, and that gets us an expected move of about 272, okay? So, and I just kind of wrote it up here in the top right-hand corner, about 273 actually, kind of rounding up. So this is a really good way to use just the at-the-money straddle price to calculate a pretty good estimate of where the stock might go in its expected range. Now, again, this doesn't mean that this is going to be more exact or less exact. You can use either of these numbers, and you see they're only off by about, you know, 20 cents or less. So both of these calculated out are pretty easy. But if your broker platform doesn't have the ability to calculate expected move, then you can use that at-the-money straddle and calculate it out yourself. Now, you'll want to do this towards the end of the day, right? So you'll, as you're going in to make a trade, you don't want to do it in the morning. You want to wait towards the end of the day. And again, try to get as neutral as possible by waiting and kind of minimizing the time gap in the trade. But this is a really easy way for you to calculate out expected move. Another way that we can do it is by using an example of Twitter. And so I'll just show you this because it's really easy to visualize instead of me drawing on the screen here. Okay, so here is just an image that we have that we took, which shows expected move. So if, for example, and this just again shows the formula, if, for example, Twitter stock is currently trading at 38.38, which it's not right now, but if it is, we take the 38.5 straddle, which would be the closest to at the money. So again, we're taking that at the money straddle, and that price of that straddle is 454. So we take that price, 454, we times it by the expected range that we want to get, which is 85 or 84. You can even do this, times it by 0.9 to get a 90% confidence range if you want to be even more conservative in your pricing and in your selection of strikes. And then we divide it by Twitter's current stock price, which is 38.38. Okay, so again, that's how we get this percentage move. So based on all of this math, if you were trading Twitter at the time that we did this video and at the time that these prices are up here, you'd expect a move of up or down 10% in the stock after earnings. Okay, so again, it's a really easy way to do it. You can look in the market maker measure inside thinkorswim if you have thinkorswim, but you don't need them to make this type of calculation and to figure out what any expected move is of a stock going forward.